I am Brother Stephen Elabo, welcoming you to Deeper Life Bible Church, Charlottesville, United States, a place where the undiluted Word of God is being preached. You are about to listen to our General Superintendent, Pastor W.F. Kumoye, as he comes forth to share the mind of God with you and your family. I want you to be ready. Pick up your pen and your paper and jot down important messages as they will do you good. God bless you and remain blessed.
You can see that God bless you. Tonight we are not going left for our miracle revival service. Normally, Ajegunle, you expect miracle. A miracle in God's law will happen in Ajegunle tonight. There's a distribution of miracle coming your way. I will get my own. What are you there? I will get my own. The Lord will put joy and laughter in your mouth. Tonight we're talking about something very important. The Word of God. The Word of God brings wonders in our lives. We're talking about God's day of visitation. God's day of visitation. Tonight, God can visit you. I said, tonight, God can visit you. And when God visits, He may visit a man, or visit a woman, or visit that little child there. He might visit your family. He might visit a community. He may visit a whole town. When God visits anyone, anywhere, unforgettable things normally happen. And tonight, as we talk about God's visitation, something unforgettable, something supernatural, something miraculous will come to you in Jesus' name. I discovered something in the Bible. Whenever God visits somebody, what that person receives depends on the person's reaction. That person's response, the person's attitude to the visitation of God. There is no doubt God is here tonight. There is no doubt there's a mighty visitation here tonight. What happens to you tonight will depend upon your reaction response to that visitation. There are two chapters in Genesis, and those two chapters are connected together. One leads to the other. One is a consequence of the other. And I'm going to look at those two chapters tonight. Genesis chapter 18 and Genesis chapter 19, the day of God's visitation. And there were many people that were involved in this visitation. And those people had different attitudes. The same visitation that God came that same day. The same visitation coming here tonight. Somebody there is carrying a miracle. Somebody there is going to get healed. Somebody there is going to get delivered. Look at that. Somebody there is going to get salvation. Somebody there, deliverance has come to you. Different things happen to different people because of one single visitation of God. In this chapter, God visited Abraham. In this chapter, God visited Sarah. In this same place, God visited Lot. In this same place, God visited the family of Lot. In this same place, God saw the in-laws of Lot. In this same place, he visited the inhabitants and citizens of Sodom. When God visits, you must understand, he visits like a creator. And when he comes to visit you, he looks at everything in your life. There is something missing there, he will recreate your life. When God visits, he visits as a great giver. He sees the lack in your life. And because he is a giver, while he's visiting that person as a creator, he's visiting this person as a giver. He visits as a benefactor. He looks at a family when he visits. And he says, Sarah, you need a miracle child. And in that same visit, a miracle child came. He visits as a healer. Because he heals. Every sickness he'll take away. Every infirmity will take away. He visits as a deliverer. And he visits as savior. That if you come and say, I need salvation. That same visitation of God that brings creation, that brings giving, that brings blessing, that brings healing, that brings deliverance, that same day of visitation will bring salvation to you. Today is the day of your salvation. But you see, God visits also as judge. Is a judge of all the earth. And he doesn't start with that. He says, can I visit your home as creator? He says, no. Can I visit you as a great giver? No, I don't want anything. Can I visit you as your savior? No, I don't want salvation. Can I visit you as a benefactor? I want to give you something. I want to do something for you. I want to perform unforgettable miracle in your life. No, I don't want miracle. Can I visit you as healer and deliverer? No, I don't want anything like that. Okay, if you don't want anything I have, I will visit you as a judge. That's what happened to Sodom and Gomorrah. They didn't want the mercy of God. They didn't want the goodness of God. They didn't want the miracle of God. I want miracle. I want miracle. I want healing. I want deliverance. Are you there? God is looking for you. God is going to visit you. He will hide his character as a judge. Once you accept him as savior, and you accept him as your healer, and you accept him as a benefactor, he says, okay, I'll go and judge other people. But if you reject him, if you reject his blessing, then judgment will come. If you have your Bible there, how many people carry Bible tonight? I said, how many people carry Bible tonight? That Bible will carry you. That Bible will cure you. That Bible will support you. That Bible, the promises there will never leave your life in Jesus' name. There is power in that Bible. There are promises in that Bible. The power there will work for you tonight. Genesis chapter 18. I'm reading from verse 1. And the Lord appeared unto him. And the Lord appeared unto him in the plain of Mamre. And he sat in the tent door in the heat of the day. And he lifted up his eyes. And he looked. And look, there were three men stood by him. And when he saw them, he ran to meet them from the tent door and he bowed himself toward the ground. That's God coming. That's the Heavenly Father coming. And he came with two angels. And God is coming to you today. Somebody there, I said, God is coming to you today. And then look at verse 10. And he said, I will certainly return unto thee according to the time of life. And look, Sarah thy wife shall have a son. Something unforgettable. They have been barren for 24 years. And now it's going to 25 years. And God said, I visit you now. This visitation will stop barrenness in your family. I was waiting for Ajegunle Amen over there. And Sarah had in the tent door which was behind him. Look at verse 14. Is anything too hard for the Lord? Answer the Lord. Is anything too hard for the Lord? Give your answer. Is anything too hard for the Lord? On this day of visitation, on this day of power, on this day of miracle, on this day of divine blessing, what are you suffering from? What are you sorrowful about? What's your situation tonight? Is anything too hard for the Lord? At the time appointed, I will return unto thee. God's appointed time has come for you. It says, at the time appointed, I will return unto thee. According to the time of life, and Sarah shall have a son. According to the word of the Lord, impossibilities will become possible. A miracle will come to somebody who has been suffering misery. Because tonight is a night of visitation. Let's come to verse 16. And the men rose up from thence and looked toward Sodom. And God went to them to bring them on the way. It was visitation in a home. For Sarah, for Abraham. After that, visitation in the city. And now he's going to go to Sodom. And he's going to declare something there. Look at verse 20. And the Lord said, because the cry of Sodom and Gomorrah is great, and because their sin is very grievous. I will go down now and see whether they have done all together according to the cry of each. What has come unto me, and if not, I will know. And the men turned their faces from this and went towards Sodom. But Abraham stood yet before the Lord. Can you see God was visiting them? And when God visits, something happens. Something must happen tonight. I'm talking to somebody there. Something must happen tonight. But different things happen. Depending on your action. Depending on your reaction. Depending on your attitude. Depending on what you hold on to. Abraham. What happened to him? When God visited, he got the promise of the unknown, the unseen, the uncountable. Because God had said, I'm going to give you a child. Through that child, many, many people will come. And they will come as your children. They will be uncountable. It was that visitation of that day that gave Abraham the reality of the promise. The promise of the unknown. The promise of the unseen. The promise of the uncountable. He appeared unto Sarah. And what did Sarah get? She got the productivity of the unexpected. She wasn't expecting at all. Because the time that women should get pregnant, all that time had passed. Maybe they say your time has passed. Today is the day of God's visitation. And what you never expected, what you thought will never come. Wonderful. I say wonderful. I clap for you. I rejoice for you. You're going to have productivity of the unexpected. And then eventually the visitation came to Lot. And Lot got the preservation of the unqualified. You see, Lot, he left Abraham and he went to Sodom. He disqualified himself. Blessings shall be multiplying in his life. But Abraham prayed for him. Jesus is praying for you tonight. I am praying for you tonight. The saints of God are praying for you tonight. Maybe you say, I'm not qualified. But you know, Lot was not qualified. And he got the preservation of the unqualified. Lot's children, Lot's daughters. You see, when the visitation comes to the father, it comes to the son, it comes to the daughter, and this visitation is coming to the young today. For Lot's daughters, they got the protection from the unmerciful. All those people of Sodom and Gomorrah, they came to the house. They said, we want to know those men. And Lot said, don't do like that. Let me give you my daughters. What am I? I know you are not merciful. I know you are wicked. I know what you plan to do. But I'll give them to you. Because I'm helpless. But don't do anything to these angels. And then those angels protected those daughters from the unmerciful. Maybe in your community, there's a wicked man, a violent man, a destroyer. They call him Mr. Terrible. They call her Mrs. Terror. And she said, I will destroy your life. And she tells you, there is no mercy. I want to announce to you, God will break their power. God will destroy their power. Because tonight, divine visitation is coming your way. And you will have protection from the merciful. Ah, the in-laws of Lot. Because the angel said, have you anybody in this land? The people that are married to your daughters.